ready to have church, you leave your home ready. Come on, somebody, to come and serve the Lord. Don't just wait till you walk into the door and just wait for everything to start. You ought to have the churches in you. So you ought to be ready before you get in the doors. Come on, somebody. That's what I'm talking about. So we're going to have a little prayer, and then after which we're going to read scripture. I'm going to read scripture first, and then we'll have prayer. Then I'm going to turn it over to the hands of the praise team. Amen. Is that all right? Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor, for allowing me to stand in the presence of your home and in the sanctuary, the pulpit area. Amen. Many pastors don't, you know, it's kind of a little funny, a little strange, but, you know, when you have the Lord on the inside of you, you can't help but to be different and set apart. Amen. Amen. And I believe that y'all have a wonderful pastor here, a wonderful shepherd, a wonderful overseer that cares about the flock. Amen. 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 So it does me good to know that you are in good hands. Yes. And I'm not talking about an all state. Amen. 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 I'm going to read you a little scripture here. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord." Not me, but saith the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I love that. Thoughts of peace and not of evil.
Yes.
Glory to God. To give you an expected end. Amen.
Yes.
To give you an expected end. Thoughts of peace and not evil. And then, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord. Let me tell you something. Anything that you're going through right now in your life, I don't know what you're getting ready to face when you walk out of those doors. But God says, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not evil. And giving you an expected end. Let me tell you something. All that you're going through, it's all for your benefit. Hello, somebody. God does not make any mistakes. He's God all by himself. He can do whatever he wants to do, when he wants to do it, how he wants to do it. Amen.
Amen.
You and I cannot figure out God. If we can figure him out, that means we don't need him. But I don't know about you, but I need him every step. I can't make a move without the Lord. I can't put one foot in front of another without the Lord. Amen. So whatever you're going through is working out for your good. Because God knows. He's an all-knowing God. He sees everything and he knows. And he knows the thoughts that he has for your life. Amen. Amen. Let us go into prayer. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus on today. We thank you, God, for allowing us to get up this morning.
Your testimony.
I can't tell your testimony like you can tell your testimony.
That's it.
I don't look like what I've been through. No longer mad now, no longer sad now, because I don't look like what I've been through. Oh God, hallelujah. We serve an awesome God, y'all. We serve a mighty God.
Last Sunday, my four-year-old daughter was sick, and so I stayed home with her, as mamas do sometimes, right?
Yes.
But it felt weird to not be here for a solid 2 weeks, because I missed that Sunday in between, so I sure am happy to be back today. And I see a lot of Williamses in the house this morning. I love it. I love it. I imagine they're here to support Miss Deborah as she comes and gives us a word today. I'm excited for that. And to serve the Lord. And I like that, the enthusiasm. I love it.
Given to me, and I cherish that gift.
Amen.
I cherish that gift. And so I'm missing her. I know she's missing me. And I tell you, honey, I love you because I miss you. And of course, you know, I'll see you when I get back. Amen.
Amen.
Now that I've got that out of the way. Amen.
Amen.
But I want to bring you to a woman of God. You all know her. I know she's a member here. She's been my sister for. Go ahead this way, if you will, and say with me, Evangelist Debbie.
Evangelist Debbie.
Preach the word.
Preach the word.
Evangelist Deborah.
Evangelist Deborah.
Preach the word.
Preach the word.
In the name of Jesus, amen. I present to some and introduce to others, Evangelist Deborah. Williams. Oliver. See, I call her Williams, so I want to make sure I get it right and do it in order. Amen. Although she's my sister, but I believe it's still being in order. Evangelist Deborah Williams Oliver. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The word is life, and the life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, to show to you that eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us. That which we have seen and heard declare we unto you, that ye also may have fellowship with us. And truly, our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ. And these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full. This then is the message which we have heard from Him, and declare unto you, that God is light, and in Him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with Him, walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. But if we walk in the light, as He is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, cleanses us from all sin.
Yes.
And if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves.
The scripture mentioned about the eternal life that which was once with the Father. You know who Christ is and what God done just for us.
Yeah.
He done it just for us, the love that He had for us. It's not His will that any one should fail, that any soul be lost. He said, this then is a message which we have heard of him and declare unto you that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. Praise God.
Praise
now, once we come into this newness of life, we begin to walk in a different manner.
Yeah.
All those old things that we used to do, we don't care to do anymore. All those places we used to go, we don't care to go anymore.
Amen.
Because there's a newness of life now dwelling down in me. The Holy Spirit has now overtaken me. And now that Holy Spirit has overtaken me, I now not have that desire to drink. I now not have that desire to smoke. I now not have that desire to assemble myself around people of such a sort. Praise God.
Speak today.
And if we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie.
My Lord.
And do not the truth.
Yeah.
So how can we say that we're walking with the Lord when we're hanging out at the corner and get the store with them so I can find
it?
We're trying to see who's buying the next bottle. We're not walking in the light if we're doing that.
That's right.
If we lie to our brother or sister when we know we have the ability to do a thing and not do it.
All right.
Lord, you are going to know we should be doing that.
Yes, Lord.
Every day when you wake up, there is a battle.
Yes,
whether you want to get up in the morning, comb your hair, put clothes on, you know, it's a struggle everywhere. Whereas it might be easy for me to do it, it might not be easy for you to do it. But with the strength of the Lord, he would, like in the Bible says, the man set their clothes and in his right mind. And so sometimes we're closed and we're not in our right mind. And so that's what we need to work on. Ask God every day to keep my mind.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't want no part to go broken or whatever, but I would like to have my eyesight and my mind. At least I can see what you're doing to me when you're waiting for me.